Dawson and the newspaper. Professor Hackety thought Mari did her work for him extremely well, and he also thought Mari had some amazing ideas about changing unfair rules. He told the minister at the church all about her and how clever she was. The minister's name was Mr. George Dawson, who was very important and well known all over England. As well as a teacher, he was an author and the editor of a newspaper called the Birmingham Morning News. An editor is someone who sorts through all the stories and chooses which ones will be in the newspaper. Sometimes editors check for mistakes, because when Mari lived, everything had to be perfect. No spelling mistakes or any other mistakes were allowed. When Professor Hackety had finished his work in Birmingham, he reminded Mr. Dawson about how clever Mari was. Mari works very hard. When she writes down what I'm saying in shorthand, she's very fast. She writes exactly what I says and she doesn't make mistakes. Doesn't make mistakes? Mr. Dawson simply didn't believe it. But she is just a girl. Girls usually can't read or write, and those who can always make lots of spelling mistakes, Mr. Dawson insisted. Nobody ever argued with serious Mr. Dawson, but jolly Professor Hackety did. Do you know that Mari writes down everything you say in church? Do you know that Mari's last name is Beauclair, which means good at learning? Do you know that she doesn't like unfair rules, especially rules that are unfair to girls? Professor Hackety was not going to give up on trying to convince Mr. Dawson, who was now listening carefully to all the good things Professor Hackety was saying about Mari. Professor Hackety also made sure he told Mr. Dawson how Mari had always wanted to work at a newspaper office. A girl working at the newspaper office? Mr. Dawson was even more shocked. I have never heard of or thought of such a ridiculous thing. The only jobs girls or ladies ever did at the newspaper building were cleaning and making tea. No lady had ever helped an editor, and nobody in Birmingham had used shorthand at the newspaper office ever before. Over the next few days, Mr. Dawson thought and he thought and he thought. He was very set in his ways, but he knew Professor Hackety was clever, and so what he was saying about Mari must be right. I'm going to ask Miss Mari Beauclair if she would like to help me change two rules, he eventually told Professor Hackety. Firstly, I'm going to ask if she would like to work at my newspaper office. Secondly, I will ask her to write her reports in shorthand. What is more, I don't care what anybody thinks about that. When Mr. Dawson told Professor Hackety about his decision, the professor was so pleased he did a funny little dance of joy until his face turned red. Whatever are you doing? Scowled Mr. Dawson, but then his scowl turned into a smile. Professor Hackety was a short man with a big round tummy and glasses, and his glasses were always bouncing on the end of his chubby nose. When Professor Hackety's glasses fell off, Mr. Dawson's smile turned into a little laugh, and that did not happen very often. Imagine how puzzled Mari was when Mr. Dawson waited for her after church and asked her mother if he could visit them at home. Mr. Dawson was a very important, famous man, and Mari and her mummy tried to think of a reason for such an unusual visit. Whatever could he want to talk to us about? He doesn't really know us, and we're not important, they wondered and wondered. Mari was worried. I think he might be angry with me, Mummy. Why would he be angry with you, my dear? Mari's mother took her daughter's hand. You are such a good girl, and you never miss church. Because I write down everything he says at church, Mari cried. I only do it to practice my shorthand, and I learn so much from everything Mr. Dawson says. He knows all about everything, and you know how much I love learning, Mummy. Don't worry, Mari's mother reassured Mari. I think Mr. Dawson would be pleased that you are interested in what he's saying, especially as you are a girl. But I know Mr. Dawson doesn't think that girls are very clever, worried Mari. I have heard him say that girls can't spell properly. Let's not worry, dear. Let's just wait and see. Mari's mother comforted her lovely daughter as much as she could. On the morning of Mr. Dawson's visit, Mari's mother felt so sure that Mari wasn't in trouble. She buttered some fresh bread and she baked a special cake and she made some extra special jam. When Mari and her mother lived in England, nobody ever ate cake before they had eaten their bread and jam. They shined their very best teacups, plates, knives, and spoons, and they made sure everything in the house was neat and tidy.